Mm-hmm. No, it's fine. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good? Joint mobility workout on this Memorial Day. Stand with your feet apart, comfortable, as much as you can be. We're going to start with the neck, then we're going to move on to the shoulders. So the first few minutes, we're going to work on a joint mobility for the upper body. All right. Feet apart, arms relaxed, and simply start turning your head to your left and then to your right. The goal is to go to the point when you start feeling a stretch, but also not too far so it's not painful, okay? So turn your head to the left, turn your head to the right. Let's keep going. Good. Start slowly. If there's no pain, if there's no tension, if there's no problems, then go a little bit faster and a little bit further. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten. Ten more. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, and ten. Good. Head back to the center. Now we're going to move the head up and down. So here we go. One, one, two, two, three, three. And again, if nothing hurts, then go a little faster and a little deeper in direction. You want to get to the point when you can feel the stretch. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten. Ten more. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten. Good. Nice work. Next one. The ear goes sideways down towards your shoulder. Okay? Ready? Set? Go. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten, ten more, one, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten. Nice job. Now, keep your feet apart so you don't lose your balance. Next one, we're going to circle the head around the neck, right? So, keep your eyes open. And it's easy to lose balance once you close your eyes and you circle pretty fast. So chin down to the chest, and now let's circle the head around. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Reverse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Nice job. Okay. Head goes forward and back using nothing but the neck muscle. So I'm going to stand sideways here and go forward and push back. Forward. Push back. Ready? One, one, two, 2,
3,
3,
4,
4,
5,
5,
6,
6,
7,
7,
8,
8,
9,
9,
10,
10,
1,
1,
2,
2,
3,
3,
4,
4,
5,
5,
6,
6,
7,
7,
8,
8,
9,
9,
10,
and
10.
And then one more exercise that's gonna feel a little weird. You're gonna move your head, you're gonna keep your head straight forward, but try to move it on top of your shoulders, like sliding towards the left side and then sliding towards the right side. What can help with this is to keep your hands in front of you. And now you see, one, one. And again, I'm using nothing but the neck muscles. Ready? Let's try it. One,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four,
four,
five,
five,
six,
six,
seven,
seven,
eight,
eight,
nine,
nine,
ten,
ten,
one,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four,
four,
five,
five,
six,
six,
seven,
seven,
eight,
eight,
nine,
nine,
ten, ten. Good. And the last exercise while standing. Imagine you are looking at your head from the top view. Like I'm right there looking on Tiffany's head from the drone. What I want to see is the head making that figure eight, okay? With the eyes pointed straight forward. So let's try it. One,
one,
two,
two,
three. Again, use the neck muscles to accomplish that movement. Figure eight,
five,
five,
six,
six,
seven,
seven,
eight,
eight,
nine,
nine,
ten,
ten. Reverse. Same figure eight in the opposite direction. Ready? One,
one,
two,
two,
three,
three,
four,
four,
five,
five,
six,
six,
seven,
seven,
eight,
eight,
nine,
nine,
ten, ten. This is not easy. It takes a bit of practice to make the head move like this. Okay, now we're going to add tension to the muscles. So, with legs apart, we're going to bend through the hips, hands on the knees, and drop your head down. Okay, at this point, you want to feel the stretch on the back of your neck. And now simply by lifting your head up and trying to look what's in front of you, we're going to apply tension, we're going to use the strength of the muscles to lift your head and then drop it back down to stretched position. Ready? Start at the bottom and go. One,
down.
Two,
down.
Three,
down.
Four,
down.
Five,
down.
Six,
down.
Seven,
down.
Eight,
down.
Nine,
down.
Ten,
down.
One, two,
down,
three,
down,
four,
down,
five,
down,
six,
down,
seven,
down,
eight,
down,
nine,
down,
20. Good, relax. From here, let's get down to the floor and lean on your right shoulder. So you're almost in a side plank position, but we're not gonna worry about the core right now. Just elbow under the shoulder, drop your head down to the bottom arm, so my right ear is close down to my right shoulder, and now use the strength of your neck to pull the left ear up to the left shoulder. Okay, ready, go. One,
down.
Two,
down.
Three,
down.
Four,
down.
Five,
down.
Six,
down.
7,
down.
8,
down.
9,
down.
10,
down.
1,
down.
2,
down.
3,
down.
4,
down.
5,
down.
6,
down.
7,
down.
8,
down.
9,
down.
20. Good. Switch to the opposite side. So, left elbow down on the floor. You lean over the top. Left ear drop down to the shoulder. Completely relaxed because we want to feel the stretch. And now lift the right ear towards the right shoulder. Ready? Go. 1,
down.
2,
down.
3,
down.
4,
down.
5,
down.
6,
down.
7,
down.
8,
down.
9,
down.
10,
down.
1,
down.
2,
down.
3,
down.
4,
down.
5,
down.
6,
down.
7,
down.
8,
down.
9,
down.
20. Good. And the last one. This one's a little tricky because you want to be almost on your back. So here's what I'm going to do with my legs. I'm going to bring my feet together, knees apart, and I'm going to grab my own thighs for the purpose of keeping my shoulders up high. So I'm almost halfway up the sit up, right? The reason for that is that I want to be able to drop my head back all the way, but I don't want to touch the floor with the back of my head. So I'm keeping my shoulders up. Okay, you can just do this without your hands and keep tension on your abs, that's fine too. But easier way is just to grab your own thighs, drop your head back, and now lift your head by trying to bring your chin all the way to your chest. Let's get ready, go. 1,
back.
2,
back.
3,
back.
4,
back.
5,
back.
6,
back.
7,
back.
8,
back.
9,
back.
10, 1,
back.
2,
back.
3,
back.
4,
back.
5,
back.
6,
back.
7,
back.
8,
back.
9, and 10. Good. Relax. Let's get back up on our feet. So we try to reach every angle possible to work on the neck muscles. And think about it. How many people suffer from the neck tightness and how many people do anything about it? Right? Nothing. It's just, oh, my neck hurts all the time. But never I see people doing the neck joint mobility. This is simple routine and it helps. So now let's get the legs apart. Let's drop the head down as deep as possible by dropping the shoulders down. So now the weight of the head pulls on your spine. And now just move your head in any direction, up and down, left to right, yes and no. Rotate just to loosen up, to stretch, to let the gravity pull the head down away from the spine for a few seconds. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly let's bring it back up. Now the neck feels 10 times better than just 10 minutes ago. Now from the neck, we're going to move on to the shoulders and the ribcage. Okay? So, very simple. Arms alongside the body, backwards circles. Circle your arms. Go backwards. Remember, don't go forward. Go backwards because we want to stretch the pecs and the front delts, which are usually tighter than the muscles on your back. Big circles. Open up the chest. Inhale as you reach up. Exhale on the way down. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. arms stay alongside your body, and all we're gonna do is this, one at a time. It's almost like you're crawling backwards on your back. So rotate your spine a little bit and then move the shoulders back. Yeah, make those circles as big as possible. Breathe. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Now you're gonna bring your shoulders up to your ears, so shrug them up and then press them down. Don't just relax, just push it down. Imagine you try to touch your head, floor with your hands, right? So up, down, up, down, up, down. On the way up, inhale. On the way down, exhale. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Five more. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. Good. Now let's try to bring the front of the shoulders together by rotating them inwards as if you were trying to touch them. And then the opposite is to pull the shoulders back and squeeze the shoulder blades as if you were trying to fold your back in half and try to touch the shoulders to each other behind you. Ready? Let's go. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten, one, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, and ten. Good. Stand with feet apart, bring your arms forward, thumbs up, and the hands a little bit wider than your shoulders. Don't bring them in front of you, but spread them apart. And now circle your shoulders backwards while keeping your arms straight in front of you. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20. Good. Reach up with the right arm as high as you can. You want to feel the arm separated from the shoulder, right? That's how high you want to reach. And then make a small tiny circle here at the top. Yes, with your index finger. But you are striving to push that arm higher and higher and higher as you make that circle. Okay? So you will feel a little bit of tension around the muscles of your shoulders. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax the arm, switch to the opposite side. And again, the goal is to reach high and then circle. Elbow is locked, straight, the movement comes through the shoulder. Good. Yep. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, three, two, one. Relax. Bring one arm underneath your back and then one arm over your shoulder behind your head. And the goal here is to move. I don't care if you touch the fingers, if you connect your hands, but the goal is the movement from one position to the other, okay? It's a joint mobility exercise. We not necessarily need to stretch here, we just move the joints through the range of motion. So let's go from one position to the other, trying to reach back. It depends on your flexibility. If you cannot touch your hands, no problem, don't worry. But keep working on it, right? Until you get better. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Bring the left arm behind your back. Try to push it all the way across to the other side. And then grab your own elbow of the opposite side. So check this out. My left hand is grabbing the right elbow right here. Got it? Then bring the right hand up to make that shoulder stretch tighter. Simple as that. We're going to drop the hips down or the chest down, push the hips back, and then drive it all the way back and push this right hand forward here to feel the stretch on the shoulders. Careful here because this can be very, very tight for those who have tight shoulders. Ready? Go. One, hips back, and then push. One, two, three, and drive your right arm forward. Four, who cares what number it is? Four, five, six, seven, eight, two more, nine, ten. Release the arm. Good. Loosen up. Shake it off. Switch. Right arm goes behind you. Grab your own elbow of the opposite side. Lock it in place. Palm forward. Feet apart. And again, stick out your butt. Drop the shoulders down. One. And then drive the left arm forward. One. Almost like a bicep curl. Two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, one more, ten. Relax. Good. And now we're going to add tension to the movement. So we're going to get in a push-up stance. The hands on the floor, toes on the ground. And check this out, guys. I'm going to slide the ribcage in between the shoulders. I don't bend the elbows, so I'm not trying to attempt the push-up. This is a little bit of learning here, because normally we just go down and up, right? But we just want to move the shoulders forward and back. Since we cannot move the shoulders, as the hands are locked against the floor, we gotta be able to move the ribcage in between the shoulders. Let's try that. So, hands apart, fingers apart, and let's slide the chest down, and then push. Two, push. Three, push. Four, push. Five, push. Six, push. Seven, push. 8, push. 9, push. 10, 10 more. 1, push. 2, push. 3, push. 4, push. 5, push. 6, push. 7, push. 8, push. 9, push. 20, relax. Good. Let's get back up on our feet. Let's move the head side to side. Let's move the shoulders up and down. Can you feel a little bit of improvement comparing to about 20 minutes ago? Right? The shoulders are not so tight, the neck doesn't hurt as much. That's the whole purpose of this exercise. Now, let's work a little bit on the ribcage. On the inhale, you want to push your chest forward like a Superman. Imagine someone attached the rope to your chest bone, pulls you, right? So here. On the exhale, you're going to cave that chest in and around your shoulder blades. Okay, let's try that. Inhale, exhale. And the goal is to move that rib cage, move all the ribs. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, it's like a cat and cow, but for the upper spine. The thoracic spine, not for the lumbar spine. Good. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One. One. Two. Two. Three. Three. Four. Four. Five. Five. Six. Six. Four more. Inhale. Exhale. Eight. Inhale. Exhale. Nine. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale and exhale. Good. Nice work, guys. Neck, shoulders, chest. Now we're gonna move to the lumbar spine. Hands on top of your hips. Feet are a few inches apart. And this is again a tricky exercise for those who haven't done this before. But when you take a look at my hands, right now I'm going to drop the right knee forward. And that lowers my right hand, it lowers my right hip in comparison to the left hip. And I'm actually trying to pull my left hip up high with the left hand, right? Now I'm gonna switch legs and do the opposite. You see my hands are going up and down. And it's not because my hands are moving, my hips are moving up and down, and my hands are just a visualization for you because they are attached to my hips. So one, one. What we're trying to accomplish here, besides looking sexy and dancing up and down, is to stretch the lumbar muscles. Okay, here. Every time I push one hip down, I can feel the opening of the quadratus lumborum. It's very strong, big, tight muscles that need some work. So, very simple movement. Watch. I'm not using my shoulders. I'm not doing this. Okay, I'm just moving my hips. So, here we go. One, one. Two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five, six, six, seven, seven, eight, eight, nine, nine, ten, ten, one. Jefferson, if you bring your feet closer to each other, it will be easier for you to move your hips. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, just drop one knee down. One knee goes back, one knee goes forward. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, and just move. Let's get five more. One, one, two, two, three, three, four, four, five, five. Good. And now, cat and cow while standing. So we're not gonna place the hands on the floor. We're not gonna go down on our knees. Check this out. Exhale. The cow. Well, actually the cat, right? I'm running my back. Inhale. Stick out your butt, chest up. So inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Again, try to control your hips. Inhale. Exhale. When you exhale, flex your lower abs. Inhale. Exhale. Five more. Last one. Good. And just to make it more fun, here's what we're gonna do next. Left, right, forward, back. Left, right, forward, back. Left, right, forward, back. Ready? Set, go. One, two, three, four.
Okay,
one, two. No, if you go faster, it's more fun. Three, four. Yeah, work at your own pace. Try it slowly. It takes a little bit of getting used to it. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All the pelvic muscles, all the muscles around the hips, lower back. Lower abs. Come on, let's get this moving. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Stretch, stretch. Everywhere you go, in each direction, every movement takes you to the point when you can feel a stretch. It should not be painful. It should feel better and better with every repetition. Five more. One, two, three, one, one, two, three, two, one, two, three, three, one, two, three, four, and one, two, three, five. I know, it's not easy, but you can get it, you just gotta practice. Feet close to each other, hands on the sides of your thighs, chest forward, back straight, reach sideways to your knees. Simple movement. A lot of people will have a tightness in that lower back and they need to do this kind of stuff on a daily basis. So it feels better, right? So it doesn't get so stiff, so it doesn't hurt. 10, 10, 9, 9, 8, 8, 7, 7, 6, 6, 5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, and 1. Widen your stance just a little bit. Bring your hands on top of your head. So this time we really have to be focused on focusing on our hips, because normally we keep the hands here and do the hip circles, right? You can get the feedback from your hips to your hands. Now your hands go up on top of your head. And now to circle the hips, you've got to control the abs. So let's try it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, good, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20. Reverse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Good job. 10, 10 more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 20. Good. Now we're going to widen the stance a little bit. Keep your knees relaxed so you don't lose your balance. Arms extended above your head. And now we're going to draw the circle with our fingers, as wide, as big as you can, using the entire torso as a mean of movement. So check this out. One. Ready? Go. One. Two. Go, baby. Go easy. Three. You want to feel the stretch everywhere. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And ten. Good. Now, let's stay here for a moment. Take a few inhales. Now we're going to reverse. Go in the opposite direction, yes? Ready? Go. One. Two. Reach as high as you can. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Good work. Okay. Hands go on top of your knees. Feet are hip width apart. And let's do basic small tiny circles with your knees. Make sure your ankles are involved in the movement. So it's not just the knees, because it's impossible just to move your knees like this without your ankles moving around, right? So it's ankle and knees exercise right here. Circle inward. Ten. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Reverse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. Let's bring the feet together, inch apart, and then circle both knees in the same direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll keep the feet close to each other. We're going to drop the hands down to the floor. Keep your fingertips on the floor the entire time. Drop your butt to your heels until you feel the stretch in your quads and knees. And then push your legs up to a full extension or as far as you can go to feel a stretch on the hamstrings. So here we go. Down, up, down, up. And if there's no pain, if there's no pressure, if there's no discomfort, you can pick up the pace a little bit. Down, up, down, up, down, up. Down, up, down, up, down, up, 10, up, 9, up, 8, up, 7, up, 6, up, 5, up, 4, up, 3, up, 2, up, and one, up, good, and slowly Springer. Nice work. It's getting a little warmer, yes? Place your toes on the floor. Circle the heel around your ankle. Open up your ankle. And at the same time, you can work the wrist. The small joints of the arms and legs. So circle, open your hand, close your hand. You gotta get all the joints. There's lots of joints in the body, right? And if they get stale and rusty, they're gonna be hurting you eventually. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. They need blood, they need oxygen, they need movement, flexibility. Let's go, other side. Especially if you injured your joint, it's important to keep working on it so it doesn't get worse. Because it either gets worse or it gets better. Choice is yours. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Good. Okay, bring your hands together. Roll your wrists like this. Very simple. Big circle forward. A big circle backwards. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Good. Legs apart. Let's get into inner thighs. Push the hips back. Drop your hands down to the floor. Straighten your legs out. And then we're going to reach to the left hand. Coco, you just don't move. Stay where you're at. We're going to reach to the left foot with the right hand. So here, rotate your spine a little bit, hold for 3, 2, 1, and switch legs. 3, 2, 1, switch. 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 3, 2, 1, one more time, switch. 3, 2, 1, last one. 3, 2, 1. Good. Let's get down to the floor on our knees, hands and knees on the ground. And then last exercise here for the hips, circle the hip, just moving your knee around. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. Good. And that is your Memorial Day workout. I hope you guys feeling better, looser, more relaxed. Now get cooking. Barbecue and all the jazz. Thank you for coming, training with us today. We'll see you soon again. Take care. Burn fat, no time. Good work.